So we start with the name of Allah. We thank Him that He gave us this opportunity to come here. And we want to take advantage of today, brothers and sisters. We are doing this so that we can improve, inshallah, and we can make the words of Allah, the speech of Allah, the highest speech that there is. And to do so, we have invited our beloved and honorable guest, Sheikh Ahmed, and his team. But before I introduce the guest, and before we go into that, we will give Ali an option, not an option, he didn't have an option, we forced it on him. We will give him the mic, inshallah, so he can start with a recitation of the Quran. Me and the team at Umar ibn al-Khattab, we welcome you here, inshallah, and we want to make this class beneficial for all of us, so please, inshallah, if there is something that you see that we can improve on in the meantime, logistically, tables, please come to me or Shu'aib. So if you see Shu'aib or me, please come to us. If there is anything else that you're like, okay, there's toilet papers running out, or water's running out, or anything's running out, please come to us, inshallah, and we will try our best. So we will give the mic to Ali, inshallah, and he will recite the Quran. Please pay attention.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم واعلموا أن الله يحول بين المرء وقلبه وأنه إليه تحشرون واتقوا فتنة لا تصيبن الذين ظلموا منكم خاصة واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب واذكروا إذ أنتم قليل مستضعفون في الأرض تخافون أن يتخطفكم الناس فآواكم وأيدكم بنصره ورزقكم من الطيبات لعلكم تشكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون صدق الله العظيم.
Assalamu alaikum jami'an, part of the community. What you heard about the sheikh, and you find out sheikh wearing something green, but don't really match. I just lost my luggage there in the hotel, in the like airport, just waiting. I came like with this, they were waiting there, Sa'iyya, and sheikh just ready. I came with them with a green shirt. I'm here, I'm Sheikh Ahmed here. Allah Yazeekum Khair. I came to you, inshallah, my name is Sheikhi, I'm from Libya. And in Libya, alhamdulillah, I have the Quran in Libya. And Libya, I'm just all over, than like I think 20 years now, 19 years there. I'm already accounted. When I came to Chicago, I told myself either like accounting or like Quran teacher. It's not only Sheikh, just Quran teacher. I focus for this goal. I'm going to be a Quran teacher. My message is not only the Quran, teaching the Quran. My message to carry the Quran message for the next generation. This is the main goal in my life now. I'm thinking, I told myself, inshallah, I will work, inshallah, to try to prepare whatever I can do for the next generation. Subhanallah, this journey, it gave me a chance to be, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, multitask for the Quran. Subhanallah, I came there, when I came to Chicago, I told myself, inshallah, I'm going to teach like this way, as a Quran teacher, teaching different levels, and I'm going to focus on not only the teaching Quran as a memorization, hifz, just only, or tilawa. I told myself, it's my mas'uliyah, my responsibility, it's bigger than just only teaching letters, to building humanity people, to carry the Quran message to the next generation. This is the main idea what I'm thinking. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. It's not saying just only خيركم من تعلم القرآن just only as a memorization. I believe خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه is توريث, taking الرسالة for the next generation. القرآن said ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا. It wasn't say ثم حفظنا ثم قرأنا. قال ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا. It means to take the Quranic message to next generation. The main idea of the Quran teaching is not only teaching the letters and tajweed, it's bigger than this to build Allah just preparing Huffaz for the next generation. That's what I believe, that's the Quranic message. Quran is not only hifz, I mean, it's Quran message of the akhlaq of Quran. كما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when they describe him, they said, كان خلقه القرآن صلى الله عليه وسلم. But that's what I believe when I start teaching Quran. And I told myself, يعني when I'm teaching Quran, I have to have message what I'm going to say. I have message, inshallah, taking the Quran memorization for the next generation. Okay, I got this. But I have to have vision. What's my vision when I'm teaching Quran? It's okay, you can memorize. Because it's not every hafiz teacher. It's not all kul huffaz qurra. It's not the all imams can teach in the Quran. SubhanAllah, it's a personal, يعني it's a specialist. But I told myself, okay, I'm a Quran teacher. I took my goal. Inshallah, this is my goal. I'm going to just give my life for the, prepare the next generation. Whatever I can do. I have to have vision. I asked myself, SubhanAllah, the same question I asked myself when I told myself, I will, what's my vision when I'm teaching Quran? That question, it came, SubhanAllah, from one parents came to me and told me, Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Ahmed, kitla alaikum salam, told me I'm a truck driver. I have a big truck driver, like couple of trucks. I'm different specials. I'm Sheikh Ahmed. I have kids. I wanna teach them Quran. What are you doing with them? He asked me this specific question. What are you doing with them? But SubhanAllah, when he asked me like this, I told myself, okay, what I'm gonna say? If I'm gonna start to explain to him everything, it's not gonna acceptable. Anyway, he just came to see what's your vision when you're teaching the Quran. When he told me that, حكى لي هذه الكلمة فقعدت نفكر صراحة سبحان الله. I'm trying to mix Arabic and English. فسبحان الله, when he asked me this question, سألني هذا السؤال, I was thinking, wow, it's a serious question. What I'm gonna answer? Because سبحان الله نحنا we said خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. سبحان الله علي ناوي قرأ last ayah. That last ayah all the time I'm thinking about. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون. أمانة العلم وأمانة التعليم, it's أمانة, responsibility. إحنا because إحنا were thinking, I told myself that question from the parents, صراحة it take me serious. I told myself, أحمد, yes, صح أنا محافظ القرآن, صح I'm, يعني I can teach, I know how to teach at least, but I told myself I have to be ready. What's my answer for them? فسبحان الله, I was thinking deeply, what does it mean, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون. أمانة ماذا؟ أمانة العلم, أمانة التعليم, أمانة النفس البشرية التي الله عز وجل جابها بين يديك. فI told myself, yes, I have to find out the serious answer and focusing answer and short answer as a vision. And سبحان الله, I was thinking, يعني this is my philosophy, and when I'm teaching Quran, especially in our community, that kids came to sit between us, يعني معانا الأولاد اللي جابوهم آباءهم إلنا للقرآن, حلقات القرآن. I'm not thinking because I was looking for the Quran حلقة أن الله brought me to the Quran حلقة. No, والله I believe this. نؤمن أن الولد هذا اللي جاء جلس بين يدي يتعلم القرآن, هذا جاء بدعاء والديه له, بدعاء والديه وبدعاء أهله. Parents' dua. He give the dua for him, and Allah guide him for the Quran. And Allah Azza wa Jal accept their dua. استجاب لدعائهم. ونظر إلى قلوب العباد. وشاف من؟ شاف قلب أحمد, شاف قلب فلان, شاف قلب علان, أنهم يعلموا كتاب الله عز وجل. شرفهم الله عز وجل بتعليم كتاب الله عز وجل. وجاب لك هذا الولد وهذه الهدية اللي الله اختارك وشرفك بها. من بين كل الكوميونيتي كلها انتم اليوم جالسين, شرفكم الله عز وجل بالقران, بجلوس مع القران, بخدمه القران, بعلم القران. فالله سبحانه وتعالى chose us to come to bring these kids علينا نحن, just sitting between us. هذا شرف, مقام تشريف وليس تكليف, ان الله عز وجل اختارنا من اهل القران. اوكي, in the same time الله will ask us about this responsibility. والله بجد كلكم راعٍ وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. فدائما I believe this is my what I'm thinking as a Quran teacher because نحنا sometimes here we thinking this community and most of the Quranic school I'm not gonna say most some of the teachers they're volunteer they're not profession to teach the Quran and they're coming giving their time for the Quran programs because they volunteer and when anyone asks them I'm volunteer I, they're not prepared themselves they're not developed themselves they're not just only they think they volunteer they do whatever they want and they just say whatever they want and they come whatever they want at the same time نحن we're not thinking in that these kids Allah Azza wa Jalla brought them by dua their parents and chose us to be Quran teacher their Quran teacher and the same thing يوم القيامة Allah Azza wa Jalla will ask us about them Allah يسألنا عليهم يوم القيامة من أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا الموضوع serious مش it's not only لأن نحن أسهل the most easier thing we can share هو القرآن حلقة أكثر حاجة سهلة علينا في الصلاة دي سكول وصندي سكول مين يساعد الأخوات بطوعة الأخ ولا الأخوات يا أجهز ضهلت نفسك علمت نفسك طورت نفسك كل لك لا لا يعني أنا أوكي نقدر نعلم باش نتعلم هذه أمانة ربي بعثها بين يديك حيسألك رب العالمين عليها مش مجرد تعليم it's not like this way yes English yeah I'm trying just our English and Arabic but at the same time we have to think like this way we have to be ready for the our amana our responsibility this is like I'm saying this is a responsibility that's nafs Allah brought her in front of you just to be what شو الريزلتس اللي يطلع لما انت تعلم حلقة القرآن in the future When's gonna be this is like هذه النفس البشرية خلينا نقول أم ولا أب ولا ولد يتعلم بين يديك القرآن ماذا يخرج؟ حيخرج حالتين two situations the results it's gonna be either dad or mom they take care of the next generation their kids they have to be ready for that their kids and next generation this is like they came to you الأولاد اللي يجوا أي ولد يجي عندك صغير يجلس يتعلم عندك القرآن As a Quran teacher, I'm always gonna think عليه هيك نفكر فيه إن هذا اللي حيكون أمامي ولد يوم القيامة حيكبر هذا الولد وحيكون أب وأم حيعلم الأجيال القادمة ويعلم أبنائه أو يقرأ هو قرآن في حياته It's very serious Or يكون الله عز وجل يستخدم في خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلم يكون كفء عليه والله يحفظه يكون حافظ لكتاب الله ويحفظ ورسالة القرآن للـ next generation This is the always when anyone came to me, I don't want to lose any one of them. This is my message for any students. Sit in front of me. I'm not losing them. I'm trying to have a built relation with them. I'm trying to have this, كيف نقول, a special vision. فهذه it's my always I'm thinking when anyone, any طالب للقرآن جلس أمامي كمعلم ضروري نفكر بهذه العقلية. It's not for fun. It's not just only to I. You know what? You're going to the teaching Quran. No, I'm gonna go. I don't have anything to do at home. خلصت بيتي وأولادي كلهم كبروا. I'm just gonna go to teach Quran. It's not like this way. Quran teaching. It's a message. رسالة تربية ورسالة عطاء ورسالة تقدير ورسالة بناء عائلة وبناء أسرة. Before just only teaching letters. فهذه the main idea. طيب. نحن الآن مثلا just make question now. Try today, I'm trying to ask thinking together like this way. We try to think together. And I want every one of you, بدي كل واحد فيكم as a Quran teacher. Do not think as a Quran teacher just only هم responsible about the Quranic vision or teaching, how to teach the Quran. It's parents too. And the parents are responsible. نحن مرات the parents we're thinking just only we're paying money. Our responsibility to pay money for the Quran teacher. No, Quran parents has to know exactly what's the levels to follow up the teachers, to know what they're gonna do, what they want to do. Some parents they're gonna come. You know what? I'm paying money. I want my son to memorize the whole Quran. خلاص, that's it. He thought إنك أنت عندك as a Quran teacher عندك magic عندك سحر أو تقدر تخلي ابنك يحفظ القرآن because I'm paying my payment. It's not like this. هي مسؤولية. فالمسؤولية إنك أنت I want every one of you كل الناس اللي جالسين يتخيل حاله إنه هو معلم قرآن أو أب أو أم عنده answer جاك سألت أنا سألت سؤال له جيت السلام عليكم ورحمة الله أنا اسمي أحمد مثلا I ask anyone of any واحد منكم سألتك أنا بنعلم ابني القرآن كيف تعلموا القرآن أو ماذا تعلمون؟ Any answer? I'm teaching. I wanna teach my son Quran. I want my son to learn Quran. What are you doing with him? Can anyone answer? تفضل. الآن نتكلم على vision. شو معنى vision؟ رؤيتك أنت كمعلم. You're gonna answer them. Answer the parents. What's your question? What's your answer? Some teacher, what are they gonna say? Oh, والله, you can go to talk to Sheikh Ali, Abu Ali, Sheikh Usama. He will answer. It's not. والله Sheikh Saeed, والله Sheikh Wen, والله لا. Okay, you can. You know what? You can talk with Mudira. It's no. It's your responsibility to answer, to understand exactly what's your responsibility, what's your vision as a Quran teacher. Anyone answer? تفضل. تفضل شيخ.
تعلم العربية الأول.
تمام، تعلم العربية. تمام، أعطاك إجابة، قال لك أنا أعلم العربية. تفضل. Yes, answer. Another. Any answer? تفضل شيخ.
Make the home a home of the Quran.
So نعم.
To teach my son Quran, I have to make the home of the Quran.
The family live with the Quran.
Yes.
الله يرضى عليك. Yes, I agree with you for the one answer. I love this word. You cannot gather the whole community and the whole family if you have listen. I have درس from other sheikh or sheikh or sheikh. It's not everyone coming to the lessons of the Quran because they have different opinion, they have different madhab, they have different thinking, different thoughts. Except what? Except حلقة القرآن. حلقة القرآن. Everyone can. يعني القرآن can gather everyone. سبحان الله. لاحظوا أنتم مثلا لما يقول في حلقة القرآن everyone's coming. If كل واحد جاي. لكن لو تعمل حلقة ثانية حلقة مثلا تفسير ولا حلقة فقه it's not everyone coming. يقال فهاي different. القرآن يشمل الجميع. طيب تمام. Listen, I'm answer. I'm parents. I'm not understanding what you're saying. عطوني إجابة. That إجابة I will كيف ما يقول نحاسبكم عليها. مش حساب إجابة عامة. إجابة أنا مش بعدين أنا نحاسبكم عليها. يعني أنا أقول له مثلاً قولي أنا شو متعلم ابني؟ فضل أي أنسر؟ فضل شيخ أي وان ترفع يدك الكاميرا فضل شيخ.
So probably again I evaluate how much he knows
the
Quran before, and then I'm gonna start from where he knows. I gotta go by a program. I mean like see how much he can memorize. I mean like. Some people they can memorize like half a page, one page, whatever. So his how much he can memorize.
He doesn't know how to memorize.
Okay, so then we have to start from the beginning. So I gotta just start with ayah.
What's the beginning?
Just the one ayah a day. Or
okay,
something.
And that's what I want.
That's what the.
تمام نشيك شوي. السؤال الثاني اللي هو اوكي اي وانا عاوز اجابه اوضح عاوز اجابه اوضح من كده اجابه تكون اوضح من كده برضو تفضل شيخ
actually they bring the kids they said teach him Quran they don't know anything
تمام
and it depends on the teacher sometimes like every 100 parents they ask this question How you teach him. Normally we focus on make him memorize and recite in good way. This is like the basic things we can do. If we go further for more, we teach him the meaning of the word because unfortunately most of the students, they don't know even the meaning of the surah name. And we go further, we give them some ahkam about like أحكام فقهية from the Quran, if that possible. And unfortunately, in the specific age, all of them, they go away and leave us alone.
No, inshallah. We cannot. That's why today we were talking together about it's our vision today. It's not only educational vision. اللي هي تربية أو دعوة vision style. يعني أنا الآن يشوف فيها جاي معي أخونا محمد. I have students. واحدة بدأت تتجوز. Some one girl بدأت تتجوز. She wanna get married. She's not gonna answer her خطيب until I give her permission. أنا كشيخ. واحد ثاني he needs just عنده واحدة. يعني قصص stories. محمد كان معي يشوف the stories all the time. But my relation مع the students never end. That's why I'm talking today. I'm not just talking about the teaching of the Quran. Our message to the Quran teacher, it's not ended by letters, by memorizing the Quran. Our message with the Quran teacher. to inshallah continue our journey with our students until they continue their journey. شو continue their journey؟ ليش أنا حكيت in the beginning إن أول ما جيني طالب I'm thinking seriously he's gonna be a mom or dad يقرأوا القرآن ويعلموا أولادهم القرآن in the future or they will be the حفاظ إن شاء الله يحفظوا كتاب الله عز وجل ويعلموا الجاهل. That kind of the goal you need to just you don't need just only teach them the Quran you need to be part of their life. تسأل عليهم تحفظهم تبني علاقات معهم تتودد لهم تكون قريب منهم وتصبر عليهم. يا جماعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من يسات خيركم من تعلم القرآن أو علمه. He wasn't just saying like just only خيركم just only teaching the Quran. It's a رسالة إصلاح. هي رسالة تعليم القرآن رسالة إصلاح فعلا حقيقية. إصلاح في الأسرة وإصلاح في الفرد في العائلة. لذلك نحن هلا أنا عامل في شيكاغو عامل مسابقة قرآن كريم تلاوة مش عامل فيها first or second or third. بس ما يقول لما سألوني المعلمين حكولي what's your goal شيخ أحمد as a principal I told them my goal is not the students my goal is a family I want to ندخل القرآن لبيوتهم في الداخل. لما تفتح سورة كل يوم they're gonna recite the Quran together and open the Quran in their houses or their homes they feel like in the Quran on their side and they were talking to them. As a Quran teacher we have to have vision like this تربية نربي طالب أولادنا على القرآن لأن أولادنا في البلد هذه they lost their خال their عم their community their families and their parents sometimes most of the parents they will have their fathers they're busy the whole time. Who's the most close person to the students? The teacher. Who was the most close person? That's why subhanAllah I'm always like the parents if they have any problem with their kids just Shaykh Ahmed can you talk to them because they listen to you more than me. Why? Because I'm giving time. I have the same vision. When I start to teach the Quran, I told myself, I'm not just only teach the Quran as bidayah or as a hafz al Quran. My journey to continue with them. Inshallah, in the end of the inshallah muhadara, I will show you some videos to see the students were born here. شباب ولدوا هون. تسمعوهم. حطيتها في بداية الفيديو. كيف هم يحكوا إن هم their vision to take care to take the Quran message to next generation. هذول من أولاد البلد هذي. منهم دكاترة ومنهم حفاظ ومنهم شباب راحوا عندي هنا شباب شاب راح لستانفورد. He finished with معي القرآن. And I told him he told me شيخ I finished the Quran with you I'm gonna continue. قلت له no he get accepted to Stanford. I told him why are you not gonna go there? شيخ I wanna stay with the حلقة. قلت له no Islam needs you there. حكى لي how. I told him when you're gonna go there then open Quran حلقة. Going to start to teach the community, الشباب تبع Stanford, the Muslims, Quran, تعلمهم أدب القرآن, be a da'iya there. How I'm going to do the shaykh? I taught him some steps and he went there and continued with him. SubhanAllah, after 4 years, came back with to me. It's not only he's already in the Quran school there. And he came to me, he has a 2 huffaz from Stanford. And one of them, he's traveled now to Harvard, he's already did the same thing. The idea is not only إنك أنت you teaching them the حفظ أو to be as a professional حافظ أو just you do what your like principal asks you to do. Your message to build ummah as a Quran teacher, especially in this community, in this like country, because this country أولادنا they don't have anyone, they have only us, they have only the masjid as a community, as a family. But I'm always saying that Quran students, this is your family home, this is your bait. This is your halaqa, and your ammu, and your khalu. And our future to generate, to focus about generations. As shabab al-mujahideen halum, this is our future. But that's why when anyone wants to teach the Quran, we have to think, we have educational vision, اللي هو كما يقال الرؤية التعليمية. أنا شي بنعلم. ابن هذا بشين حيكون كيف ما حكى الله يرضى عليك شيخنا وما شيخنا حكوا كله. عندني فيجن شين حيكون بعد كم سنة هذا الولد. والله جي يتخيل تخيلوا يعني the situations for example and the students مثلا في Saturday school or Sunday school or any place في الأماكن اللي once a day شو if we have Sunday school for example مثلا خلينا نأخذ مثال Sunday school the Saturday night what's the situation Saturday night هذه the teacher already give the students to memorize 1 to 5 في سورة القيامة 1 to 5 في سورة الإنسان students doesn't know how to read mom's not already fit with the system the teacher her job just only to give 1 to 5 to memorize or like just open CD, just listen to the sheikh. And then that night, في الليل, يكون الولد gets stressed. والأب like he's working all the time. والبيت كله screaming, يقول لك على الولد, please memorize tomorrow, we have Sunday school. Where is your backpack? We left الشنطة. في السيارة already السيارة doesn't get doesn't came already back back from the last Saturday. ف it's with the backpack يقول لك in the car. بعدين woman just the wife waiting for the husband لأنه هو رجع من الشغل. Never held my son. Never أصلاً أنت ما تعملش حاجة تبدأ fight تبدأ like the whole night like this situation. في الصباح أنت going to the Sunday school. What's going on? Going to Sunday school. الولد يكي screaming and yelling. And like الشيخ مشاري العفاسي فاتح بصوت عالي في السيارة. Very loud, this five ayat are repeating. This is the situation. We try to build our يعني, understanding what's our goal. It's better than Majid parents. يقول, السلام عليكم teacher, what's my, what's inshallah, student, what are you going to do with the students? I will do that inshallah, this year we're going to focus this level. Inshallah with this level, and this level, and this level. Our goal. Main goal. مش بعدين يحاسبك عليه. It's better. تخيل لو واحد مثلا, for example, سؤال ثاني, واحد من students came. A parent, rich, شيخ, ابن الشيخ الله يرضى عنه الشيخ أسامة جاب عنده ابن ثاني غير علي وأنا قرآن teacher وجاني الشيخ أسامة قال لي السلام عليكم الشيخ أحمد كيف حالك؟ بصراحة عندي ابني يحفظ القرآن فنمسك ونقول له نعم الشيخ علي يا أسامة والله على راسي تؤمر إن شاء الله وبارك الله فيك وحاضر إن شاء الله ما عليك أنا حنحفظ ابنك القرآن Do you think it's right answer? Right or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong.
Why?
You don't know if he is He's able to learn.
Yes, he's already able. That's why when you learn Quran, students, we're going to talk about it. We're going to talk together about the إدارة الحلقة. Before you make any plan with them, you have to know the background, families, situations, personality, how they're going to work, how's the family situations, how they're focusing. Some students they have ADHD, and you give them like homework books like anyone. And some students, they're shy. You have to understand the background of the student's situations. When you're going to start to teach anyone, it's not only your planning and just what you just continue together. You have to have their plan based on what? Based on what? Their situation, their educational level, their levels, they're coming, how many days they're coming. So you have to, and we're thinking like this way. Okay, scenario again. I said, mom, And dad, in the future, they know how to read the Quran. They can read the Quran. They memorize the Quran. Okay, this is the our vision, our رؤية لأي ولد وبنت. Based on this vision, what's our answer? Are we gonna say نعلمهم العربي كما حكى الشيخ؟ أو مثلاً gonna say we will teach them يحفظ القرآن كما حكى شيخنا؟ Or we have to have comprehensive vision. Number one. Number two. We're not promise. As a Quran teacher, we never promise any family we will do. You always say, we will help him to do. We will guide him to do. ما عمرنا ما نقول كمعلم قرآن ما عليك إن شاء الله ابنك حنخليه يقرأ القرآن. What about if it's not gonna happen? حيجيك الأب يقول لك شو عملت انت؟ فإتس فيري سيريس فشو تحكي له؟ أنا إن شاء الله حنساعدك إن شاء الله خلي ابنك يقرأ يتعلم كيف يقرأ القرآن يتعلم كيف يحفظ يتعلم كيف كذا يتعلم كيف كذا This is your promise as a Quran teacher Never promise parents something he is not by your hand دائما عطيه الأيدية كيف أنا أتعلمك تمام؟ أنا من السادة السادة ما خذيتش في الأنسر تفضل شيخ عندك إجابة؟
Yeah but the thing is that if parents knows Quran they memorize it and they bring their kids if they're not living with the Quran They are not following the Quran on the Saturday night, watching a movie, and in the morning bringing the kid. How he gonna learn? He sees that the parents are watching the movie or doing.
I agree. That's why I'm saying that more and more. Our responsibility is not only teaching the Quran. Our responsibility إحياء الناس. Our responsibility to help people. It's not judging people. نحن البروبلم عندنا if we're gonna learn how to read the Quran I saw one of the sisters she ما شاء الله she finished the old تجويد إجازة recitation ما شاء الله she has the مبتدئ أو المتقدم كذا والله you're talking to the Trump and you cannot talk to her it's so hard when I'm talking to her she doesn't know how to read she's judging all the time and I told her what are you doing just you need to support the community do not ما في حدا she doesn't want to sit with anyone all the time they're not bad they're not good you don't know how to read this one not doesn't know how to read. This teacher doesn't know how to read, and she's principal. I ask her, okay, to care of the students, some teachers. And after 6 months, when I ask her, how's the new teacher? She said, she doesn't know good. She's doing good. She doesn't get. Okay, what did you do with them? Said, Sheikh, well, I told them they're not listening. I said, what's your responsibility? But sometimes some teachers, when they get special knowledge, they start to judging others and judge the community. And all the time, خلاص, we throw the problem for the community. This is the all the time. It's our responsibility. That's my point. That's my point. إن الله عز وجل يوم القيامة والله يا جماعة كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. Allah send you this kid, this girl. It's amana between you, with by your hand. Allah will ask you. Take it seriously. It's not easy. It's not game. أنت تعلم في the word of Allah عز وجل كتاب الله عز وجل. تمام. I don't want to take long. What's فضلش؟ Yes.
Always around the learning. Like it depends on the age of the kid, right? So if it's very young, I wouldn't, the positive experience I'm going to create, it will be different from the positive experience I'm going to create for the bigger kid. That is just, يعني مقبلات.
No.
When the kid, when I create شهية عند الكيد to accept my teaching, and I will keep the positive experience going on with sabr, then I will find lots of doors to activate for teaching.
الله يفتحك. الله هو لا هي سبحان الله أنت حكيتي ما هي that's why نحنا we talking it's comprehensive vision. شو معناها؟ عندك حاجة أنت تكون واضحة عندك الرؤية التعليمية بالضبط شو تعلم؟ لأنكذا الرؤية التعليمية is not enough. أنا أعلمك كيف يقرأ وكيف يحفظ كيف كذا كيف كذا. بس at the same time it's not gonna build relation. بدك تبدأ تصلح حاله تخليه يحب القرآن. شو بدك تعمل؟ فyou have to have steps. بدك تخليه إنسان يحفظ. فتكلموا عليها إن شاء الله. فالآن أول شيء لما جيني أب يقول لي كيف نعلم ابني القرآن؟ كأب he doesn't need a lot of explanation. He just need a vision. فالvision هذه تكون أنت كمعلم القرآن بهذا vision. That vision شو اسمها educational vision. شو هي؟ هنتكلم عليها هدف تعليمي مهاري. ذات هدف تعليمي مهاري ما هو؟ هذا الهدف التعليمي. Please, I it's better to everyone write down to understand exactly what you're gonna say. The parents, when they're gonna come to you, they need short answer. They need short answer. They not. They don't need specific like talking about تجويد or talking about حكم. No. You're gonna give them حاجة اسمها الرؤية العامة. الرؤية دائما قصيرة الكلام. فتتكلم. فماذا تقول له؟ تقول له والله إن شاء الله هكذا. إن شاء الله شن تعلمه ابني؟ هنعلم ابنك أن يقرأ أي آية من كتاب الله بإتقان. شو معنى بإتقان؟ Can anyone let me know what does mean إتقان؟
أحكام
التجويد. خلاص you covered أحكام التجويد. أنا my door my مسؤوليتي حنعلم ابنك أن يقرأ أي آية من كتاب الله بإتقان. وأن يفهم أن يراجع أي آية من كتاب الله بإتقان. This is the main